For the past 1,000 years, humans have been under the constant threat of demons. They are immortal creatures with super strength, hyperhealing, and have magical abilities called blood demon art. They can appear seemingly out of nowhere and are driven by an insatiable hunger for human flesh since it provides them with greater strength. The only way humans can defeat these powerful adversaries is by exposing their bodies to sunlight directly or through Nitrine Blade decapitation. But these methods come at a high cost and mean the vast majority of demon slayers will die at a young age, leaving them with an ultimate choice of dying as a human or becoming a demon themselves. It is through this choice that Demon Slayer explores its themes of loss, family, friendship, and the struggle between good and evil. While most series would paint all the demons as irredeemable monsters, they are viewed slightly differently throughout the eyes of the main character, Tanjiro Kamado. Don't get me wrong, it's not as if Tanjiro is somehow trying to befriend the demons and avoid killing them. The story explicitly states and shows on multiple occasions how Tanjiro will kill any demon he comes across for the sake of preventing any more of the human suffering that he went through. But that does not mean the demons aren't also in pain. They are often said to be cowards that could not face the challenges that life brings and ran into what they believed would better their situation. Unfortunately, this is far from the truth that would await them. In this war, demons are only expendable soldiers who are doing their best to survive and can also be considered casualties of Muzan Kibutsuji. Even if the former humans are fortunate enough to retain their memories, they are still required to feed on humans to survive and will face the constant threat that Muzan will kill them on a whim. Their entire existence transforms to one where they need to constantly prove their worth and they become reduced to a mere extension of Kibutsuji himself. And when you learn who Muzan really is, it becomes obvious why demons being tied to him makes them pitiful creatures. Because even though Kibutsuji can be considered the ultimate being, far above any human or demon, he is also the most incapable character within the show, often acting as a child. He was born as a sickly human boy in feudal Japan and led a miserable existence due to his weak health. His appearance was pale and sickly, making him an outcast in society. Even after 1,000 years of being a demon, he is still deeply insecure about this human aspect of his and will kill anyone alluding to it. He hasn't been able to move past the same fear of death that caused him to initially kill his doctor prematurely. Driven by his intense desire to maintain his immortality and eradicate any threat to his existence, Muzan began turning humans into demons, eventually creating the 12 Demon Wounds, a group of powerful demons who served as his top subordinates. He would also kill any demon that failed to become strong or find leads on the Blue Lily, even though he couldn't find it himself either. All of this worked so that Muzan would be able to achieve his goal while doing nothing himself and hiding away from the demon corpse. You would think that infinite time would allow Muzan to reflect on his mistake with the doctor and on his encounter with Yorichi, but he doesn't change at all. If anything, his overwhelming fear of death and weakness only continued to grow the longer that he lived. Kibutsuji didn't transform into the demon that he is today. He was always someone that held no regard for anyone but himself. He always viewed himself above others, regardless of whether he was better than them or not. That is why Muzan still retains the same appearance he had while human, despite becoming a demon. This is also the reason why the demons in the story often cry and feel sorrow upon their deaths. Although their sudden character development at the end can be seen as cliche and inconvenient, it still aligns with how they're negatively influenced by Kibutsuji. Just like the demons that drank Rui's blood took his attributes, all the demons with Muzan's blood are forced to align with his mentality. They are unable to grow until given the opportunity in death to reflect the flaws that had turned them into a demon in the first place. That is why we aren't privy to what makes these characters tick until the characters themselves can reflect on how weak they are. Sadly, by that point, it is far too late for them to do anything about it. And that is why Tanjiro constantly sympathizes with and understands the frailty in the demons. He is the protagonist of Demon Slayer, since he can look past the outward perception and understand the person within. He sees the suffering that the demons are going through.
気をつけて。